Well, hello there, YouTube, and welcome to another live oil painting session. So just like always, excuse me, session. So just like always, these videos are going to be mostly silent. So you're going to see me working on part of a studio painting. My palette's over here, which, by the way, before I get any further, I'm going to show you what is behind the palette, because this painting has more stuff than can fit in the screen at this point. So I'm going to take the palette off for just a second, and so you can see I painted a unicorn and a dragon. So last time, I don't remember if I streamed this part. I think I streamed the frame, I don't remember. But last time I was working on this gold sculptural relief picture. So it's supposed to be three-dimensional looking. It's a sculptural relief and a frame. Like I said, when I painted this part of the background, the intention was to go back in and start to add still life like I have. So first was the unicorn, then was the sculpture of this dragon, and I'm going to add another thing today, which is going to be a orchid flower to contrast the reptile that I'm going to add to this painting. So we're gonna, I don't know if I'm gonna stream it, since most of you might be afraid of reptiles, but I am painting a series of paintings where I like to include reptiles and other animals. And so, not to get too far into that, the orchid flower that I'm going to paint here today is going to introduce a floral element that's going to be over here, which compositionally should balance the reptile that I'm going to put over here. But like I said, I probably won't stream the reptile because most people are afraid of reptiles. I tend to love reptiles, probably more than any other animals out there. But in any case, so I'm going to add a still life object over here. I'm going to draw it first with very careful outlines, and then I'm going to color it in, so to speak. If you're curious as to what materials I'm using, please check the description box for information on the materials, as well as information for my online classes. One material that hasn't made it in the description box that I will use just for mixing is this thing. It is Princeton Catalyst. I think I don't remember what they called it, but I think it's a mixing blade or something like that. It's a rubber mixing blade thingy, spatula looking thing that let's get the palette back, that I'm gonna use to mix up my drawing color, as well as maybe the color of the orchids, or I don't know. It's basically the same thing as a palette knife, but it's not as sharp. So I won't be digging into my wooden palette using a palette knife. Instead, I'll be mixing with this rubber thing that's not going to damage it too much. So like always, when you see this in the top left corner, that means it's in silent mode. That means that I am painting. When you see this on the top, that means that I am taking a break. So that should cover everything. Did I mention I created a playlist of these live streams? So if you want to watch endless, I guess virtually endless painting footage of me just working on my studio paintings, check out the playlist. It is titled Live Oil Painting Sessions with Yupari, something like that. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn on silent mode and get right to painting now. All right, so I painted in the vase first, added some highlights. I made up the light, which, by the way, the photo reference that I'm using for this, I'm barely using. So most of this is just from imagination. So just I got the basic shape and the direction of the, let's just call them the stems of the orchid plants from the reference, but I had to manipulate the light and make sure that the perspective fit, especially this cast shadow. So like I usually say, it's a combination of things, not just obviously copying a picture, but doing the best to interpret information, and in this case, compose with it. So composing with it is not the easiest thing in the world, but it's fun to do. It's fun to be able to create something that didn't exist before, rather than just kind of try to recreate what's in front of you. So I am gonna go ahead and take a break just for a couple minutes. When I return, I'm gonna start to put in the orchid plant and carefully draw out the contour of each one of the flowers, and then put in the form for the flowers, and then I think that should be it for the stream. So I'm gonna take a couple minutes break, and then when I return, I'll start to paint in the flowers for the orchid. All right, so I have returned, and what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna start to draw out the outlines for the orchids. Like I said when I started this background area, it's nice to have something that I can paint onto. So whenever you're trying to paint glass in the future, just for a future reference, when you want to paint something that looks transparent, like this, right? If I was painting my Gamsol thing, it would be nice if I had something behind it already to paint over top of it. A lot of times, if you're impatient, then you'll probably just try to paint it all at once, and I've done that before many times, but I don't know, it's just a lot easier, especially if you're painting like something transparent, like a shawl. Like if I was putting like a shawl over top of her clothing or something like that, it would just be easier to paint the first thing there and then paint something over it. Like I said, when I painted this sculptural relief, I knew that I was going to paint stuff over top of it, but it's still good to have it. If this was all wet, it would be a pain to paint this overlapping that, right? That would have smudged. It wouldn't have been able to go over the way that it did. So just a little advice when you're doing paintings like this, to think about the layering process and how it helps, especially when you're able to subtract. Like if I don't like something, I can just easily move it around. And it's a combination of all the techniques. I mean, it's classical painting in terms of structure, value, and all that stuff, but it's also a combination of alla prima painting. Alla prima means painting wet on wet. Though I did paint this wet on dry, what you saw there was wet on wet. It was first the dark, and then I pulled in the light. So I'm going to do similar stuff like that with the orchid. First, I'm going to go on with the dark, and then I'm going to add in the light. I might throw in a little bit of titanium white. I usually use lead white, so flake white, but maybe if I feel like it, I'll throw in some titanium white, but I'm not entirely sure. So again, it's a combination of all the techniques, and it's important to have a well-rounded education when it comes to painting so that you're not, you're able to fully express what you want to paint rather than having to struggle with trying to figure out how to paint it. Though it's fun to not know how to paint a thing and figure it out. It's a nice puzzle to be able to figure things out. Like, for example, I didn't know how to paint gold. Like, what color is gold? I don't know. Is it yellow? Is it green? What is it? So, I had to figure that out. I didn't know how to do it. And then I just went about to trying it, and that kind of looks like gold. I'll probably do some more touch-ups to it later, but it's gold enough for me. So anyway, now we're going to switch back to silent mode, and I'm going to return to painting. And that should be about good for the start of these orchid flowers. I do realize they're not the most realistic of orchid flowers, so I'm probably gonna go in and add another layer or two on it, just like with the still life elements on the side. But again, this is the start of the orchids. Everything is going to get at least two layers or so. The face is obviously gonna have probably up to six layers. But again, I'm painting the face from life with the Wednesday morning portrait group that I work with. So let me take the webcam out. So I took the webcam out so you can see now what it looks like. So I'm probably going to add maybe some more floral elements, maybe like a flower here or a flower there. There's definitely going to be something here to break up the continuity of the three still life elements. Obviously, this one is further away from this one, and this one is closer to this one. So you always want to consider grouping when you're composing things. Don't just arbitrarily put things in symmetrically. Grouping goes into all kinds of composition, like there's a group here of flowers, a group here, and then a group here, and then this is more just an individual thing. So just try not to make it too symmetrical or too predictable, and always think about the abstract. So for example, this is a nice breathable space in between. This is a breathable space in between the flowers. Had I put even one flower in here, I might later, I don't know, but if I put even one flower in there, that would have been probably a bit too much. So what I want is for the flowers to kind of frame. There's going to be kind of an arc going on here with the reptile that I'm going to put, which is going to be a pet reptile that's going to just kind of curve from up here all the way across. So this will serve kind of as a contrast for people that tend to be afraid of reptiles. Like I say, reptiles are usually just misunderstood creatures, and I'm not going to get into that because that's a whole, I mean, that's a whole big topic to talk about. But for the most part, the way that I painted this was wet on dry at first with the drawing, and then after I drew out the vase, it was very minimal linear drawing, really. And I started going into the lights for the vase to try to get more of that transparent transparentness to it. If I zoom in to the vase, you can see. Let's see if I can adjust the focus for you, so you can even see the dragon a little better. So you can see that there's reflections going on. The highlight is coming from this direction, which is to be the same as the light in the entire picture, so that it doesn't just jump out, like the still life element doesn't fit in there. In the reference that I'm using, the light's coming from the opposite angle, so I had to make that one up. But you can see nice little highlights here for the glass. There's a little rim here, and then the bottom part of the glass, obviously making sure that the contour fits and that the perspective fits, though, so that it sits on top of this cabinet. So remember, it's the idea is to make it look like I'm painting it from life, even though it is from a reference. Let me go ahead and zoom out now a little bit. I haven't done anything to the right side just about yet. I added a table on the bottom right side, but that was about it. I'm gonna rotate the canvas so you can see it with less distortion, probably more glare, and about there. So that should be pretty much front and centered. I'm gonna zoom you out a little bit so you can see. Obviously, now that I've rotated it, there's a lot of glare on the top right side, but that should work. So like I said, compositionally, there's going to be a pet reptile, which, spoiler alert, I'm thinking it's going to be a boa constrictor, which they are terrifying to people that are afraid of them. To those that know that snakes are not out to kill you as long as you treat them right and give them the best possible life you can give them, they're not really dangerous. They are misunderstood creatures, just like some humans are misunderstood creatures. So it's going to, I'm thinking it's going to go across here and then just hanging out this way. So that's going to complete this little arc looking almost like serpentine curve going on that way. And then of course there's going to be a whole bunch of other still life elements to go along with it. So that being said, remember that these live oil painting sessions are meant for you to play while you are working on your own studio paintings, or maybe you're studying for an exam, or maybe you just want to have a oil painting video playing on the side so that there's some company there with you. There's some you know, art playing on the TV or on the iPad or our iPhone or whatever that you are using. Remember, I have created a playlist for these live painting sessions. So I titled it Live Oil Painting Sessions with Ipari, something like that is what I titled it. If you're curious about what colors I am using, please see the description box of this video. If you are interested in taking online classes with me, again, the online classes start at just $10 a month. Again, please see the description box down below for a link to that. That should be about everything. For those of you in the US, tomorrow is going to be Thanksgiving, if you celebrate Thanksgiving. So I hope that you have a wonderful Thanksgiving. Usually, I don't really mention holidays, but I like Thanksgiving. It's a nice day to spend time with family and loved ones. So hopefully you have a wonderful holiday. I wish you all the very best in all of your artwork, and I will see you on the next one.